Hey everybody, it's Invictus, time for another solo queue series here on the channel. Today I'm going to be returning as my favorite ranged assassin and second favorite character in the game, Kael'thas. We're going to be on the Tomb of the Spider Queen. On our team today, it's going to be Sergeant Hammer, Johanna, Rhaegar, Leoric, Kael'thas taking on Jaina, Tyrande, Nova, Vala, and Zagara. So it's been a little while since I've actually played as Kael'thas. I know that I played Kael'thas as, or I played as Kael'thas in the bot game that I was showing the Infernal Shrines map on. But that doesn't really count as a solo queue silliness. I think that everyone will probably agree with me on that. However, I'm looking forward to playing today, and hopefully we're going to have ourselves a good game. It'd be a good way to start off a brand new week, but I don't know, man. We've got an AFK Leoric. Who knows what they've got on the other team, except we already know what they've got on the other team. Don't know if anyone's AFK yet, but I guess we'll just find out in a little bit, won't we? Thank you, everyone, by the way, who's been supporting the Teespring campaign. I do appreciate it. We actually completely eclipsed our goal over the weekend, and that is awesome. I truly, truly appreciate every single one of you out there on YouTube as well as on Twitch for supporting the content. It means a lot to me, and I am extremely lucky to have the fans that I do who go out of their way to spend their hard-earned money on supporting stuff that I do for a living, and that is awesome. And I would like to continue to do this as a living, and I could not do it without your all support and continued support, and I do appreciate that. We have Tyrone over here looking like she wants to try to get a snipe on either me or Leoric. Now, something that I will point out, now that all the fun, mushy stuff is out of the way, let's get back in some action here. Kael'thas is going to get nerfed. Dustin Browder has already confirmed that they are going to be nerfing Kael'thas. Nice spot heal there by Tyrone, just in time to save Jaina. But Kael'thas will indeed be getting a nerf. That was confirmed by Dustin Browder a couple of days ago. It was reported on the official Heroes of the Storm Reddit, but I believe that was on the actual Heroes of the Storm forums. Anyway, what they're going to be doing is they're going to be addressing Chain Bomb. Now, as much fun as I have playing as Kael'thas, and after everything that I've shown in the funny video series, I think it's probably fair to say that Kael'thas was due for a little bit of a nerf. I thought it was quite the cap a troll job that Blizzard did with Kael'thas, how they made Ignite completely go away, but all of a sudden Kael'thas is stronger and has even more burst than before. I thought that was special. But I think that everyone's probably in agreement that it should not be possible for Kael'thas to one-shot heroes just because they're surrounded by mobs. Like, especially like the best ones are when the Zeebo gets one-shot. When he's surrounded by the zombie wall, as shown in the latest, one of the latest funny videos that I've done. Funny video series. I'm not sure what to call that series, actually. So, Kael'thas will be changing, probably for the better. My fear for Kael'thas is that they over-nerf him. I'm not suggesting that Blizzard tends to do that all the time. It's just that sometimes they get a little too heavy with the nerf hammer. I'm just saying. I'm a Blizzard fanboy, thick and through, man. Like, and I don't even know what that saying means. I'm just saying it because it sounds good. And I would prefer that, you know, if they do nerf him, I want to see it not as punishing. But I feel like what they're probably going to end up doing is they're going to be limiting the amount of the amount of targets that Living Bomb can spread to via Chain Bomb. I did get the gravity lapse. Unfortunately, I'm going to eat two hits from Jaina's Blizzard there. And I'm going to get Nova, so there's that. Unfortunately, Johanna was turning in instead of trying to fuel for us up top. Which is unfortunate. Leoric's probably going to end up dying here as well. No, he barely got out of there with Ghost Walk. He was about to get Nova for sure. So the only deaths that have been in the game so far have been due to Nova, as if we've had any surprise about that. Which, honestly, I feel is a little bit weird that, I mean, look, everyone knows I hate Nova. Everyone knows that I don't like Nova. In fact, I don't know anyone who does like Nova except Nova players. I really do feel that there is still a problem with her. As I showed, it was a little while ago, but as I demonstrated in that last Nova game that I played, where I was literally getting 4 or 5 kills per triple tap, because at level 20, whenever she kills someone with triple tap, it just resets the cooldown, and that's ludicrous, to say the least. I'm hoping that one day Nova becomes much more of a problem, other than people just playing in quick matches, because I do think that it is a little bit silly. If they're gonna do something about Kael'thas, then, well, I think they should do something about Nova as well, who's actually right there. That's right, I can see you that time, Nova. You're not gonna get me this time around. Every Nova gets one as long as I'm on Kael'thas. After that, they don't get any more. I'm gonna back them up out there. I'm gonna tap myself off just because I don't want to die. The enemy team did get their first turn in, which is unfortunate. I did have five that I lost because of getting Nova'd, but I digress. But you know what I mean, though. Like, I think that if they're gonna do something about Kael'thas and they're worried about burst damage, then Nova's really gotta get it looked at. Because no one bursts harder outside of Kael'thas right now, pre-nerf Kael'thas, than Nova. And I don't think that that's anything that anyone can really argue with. Look, Nova, the problem with her is the simple fact that she can kill somebody in two shots. If she lands, depending on the spec, which usually people go for the bonus damage on stealth snipe. Normally Nova players do that. At almost any level, they can easily take out somebody. And I think that most of it wouldn't be a problem if she wasn't a stealth hero. Now, that being said, this is a little bit of a low-level way of thinking. You know, you shouldn't, like, higher level players aren't going to see a problem with Nova, and that's fine. But what I'm hoping for is that Nova eventually enters into the meta to where she does become a problem in the higher difficulties. To where we could say, okay, like, yeah, we should probably look at Nova. If we're going to look at Kael'thas, we should look at Nova. Almost got Nova there. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to get her, and Leoric is going to die. Had I had Verdant Spheres off of cooldown, I could have double casted Living Bomb and easily killed her. Nope, not gonna get it. Unfortunately, I'm not gonna be able to fight Jaina, especially with Vala here now. So we are gonna get the turn in on the Web Weavers. Luckily, my Fountain is off cooldown, so. By the way, let me go over the talent picks really quick. I am gonna take Mana Tap at level 4, and then I take Fission Bomb at level 7. Mana Tap, this is part of my solo spec that I do on Kael'thas. This is also the build that I go for whenever I decide that I want to really beat somebody in XP. I regularly beat Lost Vikings players with this build. Although I don't really see Lost Viking players anymore, but when we did see them, I used to beat them all the time. Which is, for being a non-Lost Vikings player, that's pretty good. I definitely do not want to get stunned by Taranda. They have a really nasty anti-Kael'thas combo up top. Given the fact that there is a Nova that I do have to worry about. There we go. Get a little bit of the regen there on the mana. And I'm looking for Nova. I know she's behind us somewhere, but where, I'm not sure. And again, the biggest danger outside of Nova is Taranda's Lunar Flare. Pretty sure it's not the real Nova. Yeah, level 10, I'm going to go for Pyroblast. Pyroblast has become the darling pick of some Kael'thas players, and I would be one of those. I love playing with Pyroblast, man. Because so many people pick Alar, not everyone expects... Normally most people do not expect to see Pyroblast. And what's so good about that is if you're able to land the Verdant Sphere assisted gravity lapse, you can easily kill one or two people. Very, very easily. Just barely missed it. Oh, she went the other way. Let's see if I can get Vala here from around the wall. I'll take Jaina too, I guess. Leoric's gonna get behind Jaina. She's probably gonna go down. I need to get away from the middle because I don't know where Nova went. Heard the Maw go off. It's gonna be our team getting Mawed. I do have the double cast on Living Bomb. I thought I was gonna maybe get the gravity lapse through the wall. It didn't happen. So we are still up by one level. Might as well just get the Siege Giants while we're here, team. No reason not to. There we go. Thank you, team. It shall be done. It's weird that Pyroblast went off before Gravity Lapse. I've been noticing that as well. Other people have been saying that there's been some little bit of quirky input lag going on in the game. I've been noticing that. Hydralisk saved. Saved Zagara there. I know that's not the real Nova. She's just trying to distract us from taking down the fort. Fortunately, she's not going to be able to. There we go. One Living Bomb, she's done. Still looking for Nova. She's somewhere at the bottom, but there's Tyrande. And again, all it takes is one gravity lapse, and that's all I need to get the pyroblast off. Oh, I was ready. You saw me doing it. I was ready for that condemn to suck in Jaina. Kael'thas, he's got the pyroblast ready, man. Just give me a target. That's all I need, Kael. There you go. Oh, I didn't actually get it. Jaina tapped the fountain, so she's gonna take a little bit of damage there. Not lethal damage, of course. Kael'thas just needed it. He just needed to get the pyroblast off. He was feeling it, man. Gonna be looking for the shimmer to coming around this side. Dodge the sentry there. Sentinel, rather. There we go. My gems are going to be the next one. That's not the real Nova. Get a lot of questions. People ask me, Sinvicta, how do you know which one's the real Nova? Normally, I can tell just based on the direction of them shooting, as well as I look to see how much damage the shots do. Like, normally, especially at this level, I don't think it's possible for Nova to get the talent that allows their decoys to deal damage. Yo, I know that the enemy team's gonna be gunning for me. I'm gonna tap the fountain and then get right back there. They're all grouped up, so if I can land a pyroblast, that would be pretty nice. I do have to be somewhat cautious of Nova hanging out in the smoke. Of course, I am gonna be going for Chain Bomb. There was no ETA on when Chain Bomb was going to get nerfed. It was just going to be sometime in the next patch. Going to land the Pyroblast on Jaina. Hopefully she runs right into her team. That would be nice. Oh, almost actually got the kill. Nova's actually right in front of me. She's right there. I was able to land it. I did see it at the top of my camera. Unfortunately, I didn't have Gravity Lapse. Sergeant Hammer did pursue Jaina enough to actually get the kill on her as well. So Pyroblast ended up getting a kill. Indirectly getting a kill. I'll take the assist. You, Leoric, for helping me out with that. So, not the best Kael'thas game so far. I did see Nova coming a mile away there. I did land a living bomb, so she ended up. I'm not sure if it spread to her clone, but either way, you really got to be careful when you're squaring up against a living bomb Kael'thas. And I'm not just saying that just to try to be Mr. Big Man on the playfield. I'm saying you got to be careful. Kael'thas no longer has a power spike at 16. It's 13 now, which is quite funny. I'll peel for you, Leoric. Get out of there, buddy. I did land the gravity lapse. Oh, this is going to be so bad. Oh, the pyroblast landed and actually killed Vala. I believe, anyway, the pyroblast landed on Jaina. The shockwave killed Vala, and then Jaina ended up dying anyway. That was pretty bad. The real Nova's somewhere over there. I didn't see her shimmer. I know that's not the real Nova. I'll peel for Johanna if she needs it, but yeah, she should be okay. She got dismounted by the Hydralis here. I know that Nova's going to be coming from this side, so I'm going to... My eyes are particularly focused on that side. I'm making sure that, A, they're not going after Johanna, and B, I'm looking for the Shimmer because I need to know where Nova is at all times. And to elaborate on the whole Nova discussion, because I know that some people aren't going to agree with that, and that's fine. That's what I like having a public forum for, because I enjoy these sort of discussions. I really think that the problem with her, honestly, just comes down to the fact that she's stealth. And there's always going to be some sort of animosity towards stealth heroes in any game, especially MOBAs. But in particular, one that can do so much damage so readily and so easily is the problem. I didn't get the real Nova there. Yeah, she's done. Oh, I thought I was going to be able to get the blind cast on Jaina. That would have been nice. I'm going to go for backdraft at level 16. It's going to be able to keep my targets in pyroblast range if I'm able to land the living bomb on them. There we go. I've got 14 gems. I'm going to go ahead and turn them in. And right now, tied 6-6, very, very low scoring game considering how much killing has been happening. Oh, Zagara, you done goofed. You done goofed, Zagara. Get pyroblasted. There's a living bomb just for good measure. Deny 33 gems. That is a big kick in the ding ding for the enemy team. Heard ancestral healing going off. That was on Sergeant Hammer. I'm going to gravity lapse the water elemental here just because I don't want it to stop our peel. In case Sergeant Hammer or Rhaegar need it. Man, oh man, that was a lot of damage really quickly there. I want to make sure that we get this boss before the enemy team rezzes. Yeah, enemy team knows that we're here, but that's not really, that should be no surprise. And they'd be silly to try to stop us, honestly. Luckily, this Nova did go with a precision strike and not go for triple tap. I did get Nova. That is the real Nova. Oh, but our decoy got me. We still got the boss anyway. Sergeant Hammer shouldn't have died. I deserve to die there because I went after the decoy. And I got stuck. I also got stuck in the stun, which did not help out at all. Johanna's going to be doing a nice job. She did a great job healing for Leoric there. Rhaegar on the spot, being Johnny on the spot with chain heal. Sergeant Hammer just got, unfortunately, she got sniped right into the precision strike. But I could have positioned myself better there. And again, I know that one of the arguments is, well, Invicta Kael'thas just does as much, if not even more damage than Nova. Again, I think that the problem, most of the hate towards Nova, and myself included on this, is the fact that she's just stealthed. I think that if she was a little bit beefier, but not stealthed, and she did less damage, I think that no one would have a problem. She would basically just be someone like a Vala, or even like a ranged version of the Butcher in a way. And I'm not saying that being stealthed is something that needs to be removed from MOBAs. On the contrary, I think it's great. However, I do think it is still a little bit silly to give that much power to a champion that honestly, the meta for Nova players right now is just stay stealth until you have somebody who's super duper low, and then you just one shot them. That's how it goes. Chain Bomb might actually kill Zagara there, which would have been nice. I'm trying to get out of Starfall. I know that Nova is going to be on her way. We are going to be able to take down that keep. This is the real Nova I'm going after right now. Unfortunately, my living bomb did not go off. Ah, you didn't need to do that. Thank you, Rhaegar. I appreciate the sentiment, man, but you didn't need to do that. I'd have preferred if he saved it for someone who was actually in trouble, but again, I'm okay with that. I won't ever complain about a free heal. That's the real Nova. I missed her again. I'm gonna Pyroblast on top of Tyrone. Oh, but Johanna missed the condemn. Pyroblast still gonna land, not gonna be enough to kill her though. Then I get Nova anyway, so. But we're gonna end up hopefully taking the game. Taronda ended up dying, Zagara died. I got Nova, but that's to be expected when you got a Nova in the game. And yeah, it's gonna be easy peasy lemon squeezy victory. So final total's gonna be 13-10. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. Number one. On the XP, no surprise there. I did stay a little bit too long going after heroes and doing the whole malarkey with the gems. But hey, I'll take it. Pretty good game all around. Thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you have a great start to your week, and I'll see you next time for more solo queue silliness. Until then, so long, everybody!